So there's really two rules for building fluid layouts. Use percentages or viewport units, something that'll size as you resize the window, and then test while you're resizing the window. Let's take a look at how this worked out on the mobile device. We went from this layout, without any changes to my blog, to this layout. Definitely an improvement. I don't have to scroll left to right to see everything on the screen. And you may notice the font size is actually a bit larger now. The font size was always set in M units, although it's actually still a bit small for a mobile device, so we should probably bump that up. Let's take a look on the tablet. In the tablet layout, we went from this layout to this. Again, a definite improvement. This is actually a pretty readable experience. And even when we rotate the screen, we end up with a nice reformatting. All this is really just a long-winded way of saying, be sure to create fluid layouts. Be sure to reflow to use all the space on the screen and take advantage of every bit you can, and be sure you adapt to different screens as well. One tool that makes reflow a lot easier, particularly across very different screen sizes, is the new Flexbox layout in CSS. This new tool lets you stack elements in flexible rows or columns.